Ông quỳ chọc. Ông chúng tôi nhập ra bạc cả một tô cái chúng là cá này tiếp thì tạm là cá anh đang đào vị cá chuẩn từ rồi mình vị cá biết cái đây lục cần nuôi chí nên mới miền nó cá một tô cá tăng sâm lúa đánh đào chụp bù xạ xây
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, before the break, we were speaking about your fellow K4 members volunteering to go to the battlefront. Assuming that K4 in June 77 consisted of about 288 people, and you said that half of K4 volunteered. Would it be correct to say that about roughly 150 members of K4 went in October to the battlefront to fight the
Vietnamese?
The Vietnamese withdrew from Cambodia on the 6th of January 1978. So the fighting stopped for a while at that day. Do you remember how many of those roughly 150 K4 members returned from the battlefield?
នៅកបួនប្រមាណអ្នកដែលស្ម័គ្រចិត្តទៅសមរភូមិហ្នឹងហើយក្រោយមកកងទ័ពវៀតណាមបានដកទៅវិញទៅសមាជិកទាំងនោះត្រឡប់មកប្រមាណអ្នកវិញមកកបួនវិញ
About 150 members of K4 went in October 77 to fight the Vietnamese. The Vietnamese withdrew at the latest 6th
January
1978.
If any of those 150
K4 members who had been fighting returned to their unit,
away from the battlefield.
So is it your testimony that about almost all of those 150 members of K4 were killed during combat?
ទៅគឺថាត្រូវបានទៅគឺថាត្រូវស្លាប់នៅក្នុងសមរភូមិទាំងអស់ឬក៏យ៉ាងម៉េចកងទ័ពទាំងអស់ដែលដកចេញពីកោបួនទៅសមរភូមិនេះហើយមិនដឹងជាគេស្លាប់មិនដឹងជាគេរស់បែកបាក់គ្នាអស់ហើយខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងបាទ
Now Friday, during your testimony, you said that possibly other members of K4 had no right to have arms. Can you explain to me how that corresponds with about half of your unit going to fight at the front?
Just a clarification, Your Honour. I would ask that the Council could put the time period. Certainly, when the witness is in the airfield, it was clear that he said there was no right to have arms. But as far as what particular period you're referring to, because the situation changed, so
there was clear to the witness.
I will
rephrase my question.
Mr.
Witness, you gave testimony to the effect that you and others within your unit had no right to have arms, no right to wear arms. To which period did you refer?
រយៈ ពេល ដែល គេ មិន ឲ្យ កាន់ កំភ្លើង នឹង តើ រយៈ ពេល ណា មួយ សូម លោក បញ្ជាក់ បន្តិច មើល
ច្បាប់ សូម ជម្រាប អង្គ តុលាការ ឲ្យ បាន ជម្រាប នៅ ពេល ដែល ចាប់ សង្គ្រាម ឆ្នាំ 1975 នៅ ពេល នោះ គឺ ដក កំភ្លើង ទាំង អស់ គ្នា គេ ដក កំភ្លើង
So the removal of your weapons had nothing to do with you working at Kampong Chenang Airfield, but it was done in
1975,
is that correct?
Đó có phải là một trong từ Cao Pram, từ Kampong Chenang.
I understand, but those 150 members of K4 who went to the battlefield, surely they had weapons? Or were they going unarmed to fight the Vietnamese?
Have
you ever heard as a military person
ក៏នងនាមលោកក៏ជាកងទ័ពមិនអ្នកដែរតែសម្មមិត្តរបស់លោកដែលមានគេបញ្ជូនកងទ័ពឲ្យទៅប្រយុទ្ធជាមួយខ្មាំងដោយអត់មានអាវុធទេប្រយុទ្ធដៃទេដូចខ្ញុំបានជម្រាបហើយអំបញ្ញមិញថាអ្នកដែលគេបញ្ជូនទៅសមរភូមិគេឲ្យកាន់កំភ្លើងឬមិនឲ្យកាន់ខ្ញុំបានពុំបានដឹងទេ
Let me rephrase then my question.
In those
roughly 7 years, including that 1 or 2 weeks that you said that you were commanding officer of K4, have you ever experienced comrades fighting the enemy without guns, rifles, machine guns, etc.
That's
what I thought, Mr. Witness.
Let me ask
a few additional questions
relating
to the period that you joined the armed forces in 1970. Up until the last day that you were commanding officer of K4.
In
those around 7 years, did you ever refuse orders that were given to you?
Maybe
something went wrong in translation. My question was, did you ever refuse orders?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមថ្លែងជូនអង្គតុលាការមេត្តាជ្រាបតបមិនដែលហ៊ានជំទាស់បញ្ជាអំពីមេបញ្ជាការទេបាទ
But you were a commander yourself.
Did you ever
give orders
to your soldiers?
Chambat som chamrep chun ong talaka. Na pe mien ka ngie da trou tveu keu banchie doch te khnia ba.
And orders, unless unlawful, had to be followed. Is that correct?
Chang mien nei tha tu bai ka banchie nu khos chbab ko doy ko trou te anuvot tam dai chang mien te.
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការខ្ញុំបាទនៅអង្គភាពនេះមិនដែលណាណាបញ្ជាកិច្ចការងារដែលក្រៅលក្ខខណ្ឌដែលត្រូវធ្វើទេបាទ
In those few weeks, you said that you were commanding officer of K-4. Did your men have roofs to sleep under? Did they have mosquito nets? Did they have hammocks in which they could sleep?
Mung kontel khnai phui mien dambol ay tram trau te.
Chen tham chen viet chun ong talaka.
So when you were commanding officer of K4, would it be fair to say that the situation was roughly the same? When you were with K4 at
Kampong Chenang
Airfield?
ដែលលោកធ្វើការនៅកបួនដែរប៉ុន្តែកបួននៅពេលដែលគេបញ្ជូនលោកទៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងស្ថានភាពដូចទៅគ្នាអញ្ចឹងឬក៏អត់ទេខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅអង្គភាពកបួនក៏ដូចជានៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងគឺដូចគ្នា
When you were commanding officer of K4, did you give your men wages? Did you give them salary?
Lok mien bak prak hai ao kong top robos lok te.
Chambat sam chambep chun ong talaka. Chab mien prak hai te.
So again, there was no difference when you were commanding officer
K4 in terms of wages,
and when you were working at Kampong
Chenang
Airfield, is that correct? When you were commanding officer of K4, how was the hygiene situation? Did you provide your men with bathing facilities?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅអង្គភាពកបួនផ្នែកអនាម័យ We ought mean some by the Kimbatjal or ought mean Mung mean Hui, the Rob River.
Is it fair to say that when you were commanding officer,
that
situation wasn't much different from when you were at Kampong Chenang Airfield?
The situation in the
Let me ask the question the other way around. Can you give us one difference in terms of working conditions, material, equipment, etc., between the time that you were commanding officer of K4 and the time that you were working at Kampong Chenang Airfield as member of K4?
I think the objection, Your Honour, is the relevance of this line of questioning. This witness has talked about being the commanding officer for 2 weeks in and around March 1977, and then at a later point in time he's talked about, he's given evidence that he and his unit were tempted for about a 5-month period. And so I'm just wondering how relevant it is during comparison of the conditions when this witness was a commander for 2 weeks, a period of time where I believe on the evidence it's not the time that this witness and his unit were being tempered. They were being tempered later on in the year for about 5 months before going to Kampong Chenang. So if the idea is that there was no discrimination at Kampong Chenang compared to when he was commander at K4, I think the comparison is better when they're being tempered at K4 rather than when he was the commander.
Well, it's our position that his unit wasn't tempered at all. However, leaving that aside, I think it's fair to make a comparison between the work of K4 of which he was commander in about roughly March 1977, possibly longer, and the working conditions in
Sorry, was there an objection or was this an observation on behalf of the prosecutor?
I think that's correct, Your Honour. I think it was more observation.
Then I'll move on. Thank you for your observation, Mr. Prosecutor. Can you give me one clear example of the difference in respect of working conditions, working times, available equipment in those weeks in March 77 and the period that you were at Kampong Chenang Airfield? What was the striking difference between those two periods?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គតឡាការមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅកន្លែងកោបួនមានស្ថានភាពនិងរបស់ប្រើប្រាស់គឺមានគេបើកចោបកំបិតនិងគោសម្រាប់ធ្វើស្រែខុសពីទៅនៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងទៅនៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងគេបើកចោប ឲ្យម្នាក់មួយសម្រាប់កັບជីកស្មៅនិងកັບកណ្ដៅតាមរឹសហើយស្ថានភាពការងារ nơi có bốn rất mong của mỗi cái dương chánh tư tam tham đà mong đọc mỗi xâm ra mong mỗi cái dương chốc phơi xa rồi hốt đọc mong pram tại nơi cái phương chân năng cứ mong bốn cứ hai bà chung chúa chân tâm ná tư ca than rồi hốt đọc mong đọc mỗi ngày trăng hay mong mỗi chốt phơi ca rồi hốt đọc mong phổ mô giúp của miền phổng phơi giúp của miền chuông cá miền đọc tư mong phổng bốn giúp đọc giúp của miền nếu xong ông ta là cá người ta chỉ riêng.
I understand. However,
when you were
at Kampong Chenang Airfield as of 15 January
78,
was there ever a sense of urgency communicated to you and others
in relation to
the war with Vietnam
in
the previous months before 15 January 78, tens of thousands of Vietnamese troops had crossed the borders? Was there some sense that the work at Kampong Chenang Airfield had to be finished soon?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការនៅពេលដែលខ្ញុំបាទនៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងមិនដែលលឺសូនណានាយាយអំពីវៀតណាមឆ្លងកាត់ទៅណាមកណាគឺអត់ដែលលឺសូនណានាយាយទេខ្ញុំបាទរស់នៅក្រុមណាគឺធ្វើការនៅក្រុមនោះតាមធម្មតាធម្មតា
Let me rephrase my question. You started working at Kampong Chenang Airfield on 15 January 1978. What had happened 9 days earlier, 6 January 1978? Do you recall in terms of the end of the war or the withdrawal of troops? Do you remember anything?
បញ្ចប់ហើយឬក៏ថាកងទ័ពវៀតណាមបានដកទៅវិញលោកមាននៅចាំចំណុចនេះទេ
ខ្ញុំបាទប្រហែលដឹងទេណា
you were from the original north zone
មកព
ី
ភូមិភាគឧត្តរ
ជាអ្នកដែល
មានមកពីភូមិភាគឧត្តរមានទំនប់6មករាន
ៅភូមិភាគឧត្តរ6 January dam
អញ្ចឹងលោកមានដឹងទេថានៅភូមិភាគឧត្តរនឹងមិនគេហៅទំនប់មួយនឹងហៅថាទំនប់6មករា
ចាំបាទខ្ញុំបានដឹងខ្ញុំមិនដែលឃើញផងបាទ
You also gave testimony that a month after you had arrived at Kampong Chenang Airfield, you were sent to Phnom Penh for 3 months,
education to become a surveyor. Did
they tell you why they had chosen you?
តើគេមានប្រាប់លោកថាហេតុអ្វីបានជាគេជ្រើសរើសរូបលោកឲ្យទៅចូលវគ្គរៀនសូត្រខ្លះជាអ្នកវាស់ដី3ខែនេះទេ
សាប្រេងខ្ញុំសូមជំទាស់គឺថា
2ខែក្រោយពេលគាត់ទៅដល់កំពង់ឆ្នាំងទៅគេជ្រើសរើស
2 months did they tell you why
បានសូមកែប្រែ2ខែ
why you were chosen to be able to do this education
ថាហេតុអ្វីបានជាគេជ្រើសរើសរូបលោកឲ្យមករៀនសូត្រនៅភ្នំពេញទៅជាអ្នកវាស់វែងដីធ្លីនោះ
សំណួរនេះខ្ញុំបាទដូចជាឆ្លើយពីថ្ងៃសុខនេះចាប់អស់ហើយហើយសួរនេះសួរសាកដែរដែរវិញហើយខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គតុលាការសារជាថ្មីម្ដងទៀតថានៅពេលនោះគឺមានម្នាក់គេឈ្មោះបង្ហានបានស្គាល់ខ្ញុំហើយសុំឲ្យខ្ញុំទៅរៀនផ្នែកខាងបច្ចេកទេសនេះដូចខ្ញុំបាទបានឆ្លើយពីថ្ងៃសុខរួចហើយ
I know you did, but Han was from Division 502. You were from division
Did your commanding officer tell you why you were chosen to go to Phnom Penh?
Why was it you that your commanding officer told you why your choice had fallen upon you to become a high security
But
you said you have been a commanding officer of K4. Then while you said that your unit was tempered, but then all of a sudden it seems you were asked to go for this 3 months education training in Phnom Penh. Did they tell you why all of a sudden you were perceived as a loyal cadre again?
លោកគឺគេមិនទុកចិត្តឲ្យក្រោយមកគេមានប្រាប់លោកថាលោកខ្លាយទៅជាកម្មអភិបាលគួរឲ្យទុកចិត្តវិញអញ្ចឹងចំណុចនេះខ្ញុំពិបាកនឹងឆ្លើយជូនតែខ្ញុំកំបាត់កាន់អសុំរៀបរាប់អំពីសំណួរដែលលោកមេធាវីកាលពីក្រោយចោទសួរខ្ញុំនេះថាមូលហេតុអីបានជាគេដកស្រីទុកចិត្តហើយទុកចិត្ត ຈັ່ງເຕີຂ້ອຍບາດສົມຈໍາລຽບຖ້າຂ້ອຍບາດກ້ອຍປີການຈັບເມເມໃນກອງປົນກອບ4ອັດຂ້ອຍບາດຖືດອກຕະນຶລົດດໍາ5ខែក្រោយນີ້ຫມໍທີ່ປະຊຸມຂ້ອຍບາດໄປກະປົງຊ្នាំໄປກະປົງຊ្នាំບານ2ខែນັ້ນທີ່ເອົາຂ້ອຍບາດມາຮຽນທາງທາງໃດນີ້ຂ້ອຍບາດຈໍາລຽບຈູນໄປຖ່າຍສົບຮູດມາໃຫ້
Let me ask it differently. Was it a promotion
for
you to become a surveyor, or was
it a demotion?
Mr. Witness, but not
before
putting to you that you have been a loyal revolutionary cadre from 1970 all the way up till 1979, you were never refreshed. Is that correct?
ស្មោះត្រង់រហូតដល់ឆ្នាំ1969តើខ្ញុំនិយាយយ៉ាងដូចនេះត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេគឺលោកជាកម្មាភិបាលបាទស្មោះត្រង់រហូតដល់ឆ្នាំ1979ចំបាត់សំជំរាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសំណួរនេះសួរសារចុះសាឡើងហើយដូចជាមិនមានអង្គហេតុណាមួយដែលធ្វើឲ្យខ្ញុំបាទឆ្លើយបានសំណួរនេះហាក់ដូចជាសួរ
ចំពោះសំណួរច្រំដែលសំណួរដែលហាមឃាត់នោះគឺអង្គជំរះបានជម្រាបជូនភាគីរួចហើយហើយមធ្យោបាយដែលដោះស្រាយបញ្ហានេះមានពីរទីមួយលោកស្ដាប់ហើយភាគីម្ខាងម្ខាងសុទ្ធតែមានសិទ្ធិជំទាស់ទៅនឹងការតាំងសំណួរមិនច្បាស់លាស់សំណួរច្រំដែលឬក៏ប្រភេទសំណួរណាដែលច្បាប់ហាមឃាត់ទី 2
I'll repeat my question, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, is it true
that you have always been a loyal
revolutionary cadre from 1970 all the way up to 1979,
that in fact you have never been tempered or refashioned? ហើយ លោក មិន តែ ត្រូវ បាន យក ទៅ អប់រំ កែ ប្រែ ឬ ក៏ លុត ដំ អ្វី នោះ ទេ
ច្បាប់ សំ ឆ្លើយ ជូន អង្គ តុលាការ តាំង ពី ឆ្នាំ 70 មក ទល់ 75 ច្បាប់ នៅ ទី ត្រប់ មិន ដែល មាន បញ្ហា អ្វី តែ ក្រោយ 75 ໃນឆ្នាំ 77 ដែលខ្ញុំបានជម្រាបថាគេយកទៅលុតដំគឺនៅជាយុទ្ធជនរុតដំគឺយុទ្ធជនរបស់គ្នាបាទ Fine
Mr. Witness, I will move on. Do you know when
សូមអរគុណ ខ្ញុំ សូម បន្តទៀត
The Division 310 Chief
តើលោកដឹងដែរឬទេថាហេតុអ្វីបានជាកងពលប្រធានកងពលបៃរុក 10 អឿននោះត្រូវបានគេចាប់ខ្លួនតើលោកដឹងមូលហេតុនៃការចាប់ខ្លួនរបស់អឿននេះទេ
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការ ខ្ញុំបាទពំបានដឹងទេ ដឹងនៅពេលណាដែលគេហៅទៅឲ្យរៀនហៅស្ដាប់នៅខ្សែអត់ដូចខ្ញុំបាទបានជម្រាបផងដែរ
I understand, but I'm asking because there might be some confusion as to his day of arrest. Was he arrested on 4th of March 1978, or was he arrested a year earlier? I understand, but was it February, March 1977, or was it February, March 1978?
មីនា ឆ្នាំ 1977 ឬក៏ ឆ្នាំ
1978 សំបជាក់ ម្ដង ទៀត ខ្ញុំបាទ ត្រាប់ អត់ បាន
Un, the chief of Division 310, of which you were a member for 9 years, was he arrested in
March, February 1978.
Very well. For the record, Mr. President, there is a document E3/1993, which would imply that Un was arrested on the 4th of March, 1978. And you were speaking about Thak Kim. Was that the other name of ex-deputy political commissar Sao Kun?
Oui, Maître Copé, vous venez de faire référence à un document, je n'ai pas très bien compris de quel document il s'agissait. Pour que ce soit également noté au transcript de l'audience, j'indique que dans la liste révisée des prisonniers de S21, le document E3/342, à la page 391 et à l'entrée 89-67, est mentionné l'arrestation du nommé Sbov Im, alias Un, membre de la division 310, et la date d'arrestation indiquée est le 17 février 1977. Je précise également que figure au dossier des aveux de nommé Sbov Im, alias Un ou Eun. C'est le document
E3/1983, which says that Un was arrested on the 4th of March, 1978. That's why I was asking for clarification. But I'll thank you but my question was about Thak Kim. Was he the same as Sao Kun, True, but was his real name Sao Kun?
Do
you know, Mr. Witness, what the relation, if any, was between Un, Vun, Kim on the one hand, and Khoi Thun on the other hand? Have you ever heard that Khoi Thun was arrested because he was preparing a coup d'etat in January 1977?
Yes.
Have you ever heard that Khoi Thun used forces from Division 310?
Khoi Thun nung quat tau peng peak kong
pol bay roi dap.
Dam bay rip phan ka thu rot pa ha nung dai ri te.
Khem bat pom ban dang te.
Earlier this morning, you spoke about weapons being
transported.
And you saw that you were asked to mind your own business. Were these weapons transported to Phnom Penh in January
1977?
I understand, but was it shortly before January 1977? The coup d'etat was supposed to take place in January 1977, those weapons were shipped or sent just before that?
The objection is in response to the question. It's a leading question, and I'm wondering where the information is based. To put this question to
the witness. I'm
not making it up. It's extensively documented by Keenan in the Pol Pot regime that the attempt at coup d'etat was supposed to take place on the 17th of January 1977. But I'll move on. Because of time. Mr. Witness, I think you are also quite familiar with a town in the north of Cambodia, Siem Reap. Were you at one point in time stationed in Siem Reap? But in your DC camp statement, I read that you have been in Siem Reap at one point in time, as a soldier between 1975 and 1975.
Fair
enough. Do you know what happened in Siem Reap
on the 25th of February 1976?
Have you heard around that time of reports of military uprising and bombing by jet fighter planes in Siem Reap? Have you heard anything about what happened in Siem Reap in February 1976?
No,
ខ្ញុំបានដឹងទេនៅខេត្តសំរាប
Have you heard of intensive fighting?
Ta lok lop lue kien jem pi cham bang ha da da kukuk
in the area of Siem Reap.
Yen na khnom chnam 1976 pa hai che nau ma dom Siem Reap nei kong toap patavot dai rue te mien ka pyot khnia nau Siem Reap
ខ្ញុំបាទខ្ញុំដែលដឹងទេ
Then I will return to what you said about the weapons
មកលើខ្ញុំសូមត្រឡប់មកនិយាយតាក់ទងនៅអ្វីដែលលោកបានលើកឡើងតាក់ទងនឹងអាវុធដែលគេបានដឹក
Can you do your best again and try to remember when exactly
បាទជាថ្មីម្ដងទៀតសូមលោកព្យាយាមចងចាំពីអ្វីដែលគេបាននិយាយទៅកាន់លោកនៅពេលដែលគេនិយាយប្រាប់លោកថាកុំគិតរឿងគេគិតតែរឿងខ្លួនឯងទៅបានហើយតើលោកអាចរៀបរាប់ជូនតុលាការបានដែរឬទេថាលោកចងចាំអ្វីខ្លះពេលណាដែរ
ចាំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គតុលាការនៅថ្ងៃខែឆ្នាំចាំបាទខ្ញុំបានចាំទេតែនៅពេលនោះខ្ញុំបានឃើញគេដឹកកំភ្លើងទៅហើយឈប់មកកន្លែងខ្ញុំបាទនៅរួចហើយខ្ញុំបាទសួរគេថាអឺកំភ្លើងនេះគេដឹកទៅណាគេថាកុំចេះហើយអ្នកពិការបន្តិចទៀតគេដឹកទៅក្រោយអស់ហើយឲ្យឯងនេះជាពាក្យព្រមានរបស់អ្នកដឹក
Do you know how many months that was before you became the K4 commander?
Ta lok dang dai rue te tha bantop pi nang mao nung proman khae neu pe dai ke taing tang lok oy khlai chea prathean ko 4 ne pe le lok khoeng ke dak avut dak ay nung khom sua tha ryak kamliet khnie proman ban ke taing tang lok thoe prathean ko 4
សត្វតែមកតនឆ្លើយតបសូមជួយថាបញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិ
សាប្រញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិ
you know perhaps the question should be how many months it was before or after
លោកសេចក្តីក្រុមជាតិគោរពលោកខ្ញុំក៏ដែរគួរតែសួរថាតើមុនពេលដែលគាត់ត្រូវបានគេតែងតាំងជាប្រធានក4នឹងរយៈពេលប្រហែលខែឬក៏ក្រោយពេលនឹងប្រហែលខែហើយតាមតែច្បាស់មិត្តវិកូពេបាទឡើងខ្ញុំអាចរៀបសំណួរឡើងវិញបាន
តើ
លោកខ្លាយជាប្រធានក4នឹងប្រហែលខែហើយបានលោកឃើញគេដឹកអាវុធមកនឹងហើយពេលដែលលោកនិយាយទៅគេថាគិតតែរឿងខ្លួនឯងទៅបានហើយ
សម្បត្តិសំជម្រាបជូនអង្គតឡាការពំបានចាំខែថ្ងៃទេណាអូយូហើយ
maybe I'm wrong
សំណួរប្រហែលជាខ្ញុំច្រឡំទេមើលទៅ
commander seems to have a relation to
ក៏ប៉ុន្តែទទួលនទីរបស់លោកជាមេក4នោះបើជាតកតងទៅនឹងការចាប់ខ្លួននឹងមេចាក់ផងអតីតមេក4នេះនៅពេលដែលលោកខ្លាយជាប្រធានក4នោះ
តើវាអាចមាន
ទំនាក់ទំនងអ្វីមួយនឹងការដឹកអាវុធចូលមកដែរឬទេតើលោកអាចព្យាយាមរំលឹកឡើងវិញហ្នឹងអំពីអ្វីដែលកើតឡើងនៅថ្ងៃដែលគេប្រាប់ឲ្យលោកគេប្រាប់លោកថាកុំចេះដឹងរឿងគេនេះ
ចាំបាទសូមឆាជូនអង្គតុលាការនៅពេលដែលគេនិយាយថាឯងកុំចេះគឺប្រើរយៈពេលវែងបានខ្ញុំបាទបានទទួលឋានៈជាប្រធានគ្រប់គ្រងអង្គភាពក4គឺយូណាវាខុសពេលវេលាគ្នាបាទ
Let me help you a little bit, Mr. Witness. There
is evidence that suggests
that your predecessor, Commander of K4, was attending a general staff meeting in October 76. He was arrested in March 77. Were you told to mind your own business between October 76 and March
77?
I'm seeing that it is 4 o'clock, Mr. President.
Maybe it's time to stop.
សម្រាប់ការលើកថ្ងៃនេះដល់ពេលជប់សម្រាកហើយហើយមានប្រកាសផ្អាកកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះត្រឹមនេះសកម្មការលើកទៅបន្តធ្វើនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកថ្ងៃអង្គារទី16ខែមិថុនាឆ្នាំ2015ដែលចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកតទៅសកម្មការនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកនេះអង្គជំរះនឹងធ្វើសកម្មការបន្តស្ដាប់លក្ខិកម្មសកស័យកៅលឿបញ្ចប់ហើយអង្គជំរះក៏សូមជម្រាបជូនដំណឹងដល់ភាគីនិងសាធារណជនបានជ្រាបផងដែរថាសកស័យដែលត្រូវផ្ អង្គជំរះអាចនឹងស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មសាក្សីដែលមានរាជនាម PTC W830 សម្រាប់អង្គហេតុការដ្ឋានទំនប់1មករាមុនការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មសាក្សីដែលមានរាជនាម PTC W901 ហើយដូច្នេះសូមពេលគីជ្រាបនិងរៀបចំខ្លួនសម្រាប់ការធ្វើសម្ដែងការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មសាក្សីឲ្យបានទាន់ពេលវេលាអង្គជំរះសូមអរគុណលោកកៅលឿដំណើរការសម្ដែងការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មរបស់លោកក្នុងឋានៈជាសាក្សីនៅមិនទាន់ចប់នៅឡើយទេអង្គជំរះក៏អញ្ជើញលោកឲ្យមកបន្តផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មនៅព្រឹកថ្ងៃស្អែកទៀតដែលនឹងចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកទៅហើយសម្ដែងការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មរបស់លោកនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកនេះចំណងមិនដល់មួយព្រឹកទេឥឡូវនេះលោកអាចសម្រាកបានហើយមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលតឡាការត្រួតរួចជាមួយនឹងបុគ្គលិកនៃអង្គភាពគាំពារសាក្សីនិងអ្នកជំនាញក្នុងការជូនសាក្សីកែលឺវិលត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់កន្លែងដែលគាត់ថ្នាក់នៅវិញចុះនឹងឲ្យអញ្ជើញគាត់ត្រឡប់មកចូលរួមសម្ដែងការនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្ដែងការនេះវិញនៅព្រឹកថ្ងៃស្អែកបានមុនម៉ោង9ប្រកបឲ្យអន្តរាគមន៍ទីឃុំឃាំងនាំខ្លួនទៅជន់ចាប់ចោតនួនជានឹងខៀវសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់មន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនៃអវតកវិញចុះនៅប្រកបឲ្យនួមខ្លួននាំខ្លួនពួកគាត់ទាំងពីររូបត្រឡប់ចូលរួមសម្ដែងការនៅព្រឹកនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកឲ្យបានមុនម៉ោង9ព្រឹកសម្រាប់ចុះ
សូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ